all-natural synergistic herbal formula enhancing hair growth and follicle rejuvenation. Hair links.
We cannot understand by the mind or by science. I don't know how God works, so I can't tell you. And what is a miracle? A miracle is something that you cannot define.
Do you have any empirical evidence or
okay, now, wait, let me stop you right there. Now your mind is trying to have a proof of something that is beyond the mind.
Okay.
Because proof requires knowledge. Knowledge requires science.
Mm-hmm.
And science requires proof.
Mm-hmm.
And all of these are the tools that are not capable of measuring or realizing what is spirit or God and all that.
Hmm.
So you're not, once you talk about proof, then you're talking about a tool that is not capable of proving. Or as soon as you say proof, then you're going to the mind.
So you think we will never find proof that there is a God, or there will never be proof that there is an afterlife?
I don't know how to answer that question. But all I know right now is that I don't need any proof because the mind is much smaller than that. Or the science is like, for example, let's talk about science and nutrition. Or let's talk about science and space. 500 years ago, what was the scientific belief about the universe?
That we were flat.
Yeah, that Earth was flat. And we just knew that there are stars up there, and we thought it's up and then down.
A dome over there.
Yes.
Right.
And then later we realized, someone said, no, Earth is not flat, and they killed him, and they just, right? And then, because he couldn't prove it at the time. And just because he couldn't prove it, or it was against the religious, beliefs, then they killed him. So later on we realized, okay, there is solar system. Oh, there is more. Okay, the sun and everything. And then later we realized that, okay, there is a galaxy. And we thought, okay, the whole, everything is that galaxy, the Milky Way. And then we realized, okay, no, there are billions of these galaxies. And we realized that there are billions of stars in every one of these galaxies. And every one of these stars could be a million size bigger than our sun. Did we know all of this about 300 years ago? Or 400 years ago? What was science then? Science was there, and science was incapable of proving that. But that didn't mean that they don't exist.
Hmm.
So in other words, what I'm trying to impress upon you is, just because science or logic or our limited mind cannot prove something because we are looking in a box, and what we are trying to prove is something out of the box, whether it's there or not, we can never use that tool to prove that.
Well, it's certainly true that we're only using a small fraction of our brain, right? So in the future, do you think we will have evolved to use more of our brain, and maybe we'll find out that the behavior of an atom, which is so similar to, stars orbiting a galaxy, maybe an atom is itself a universe?
Yeah. I believe that.
You do?
Yes, I believe. What you just said, it's exactly my core belief. Or a single cell, or everything. You could see the whole universe in a single cell. So, in other words, it is our reality is what we believe in. And what is the truth, we cannot understand by the mind or by science. Science can never tell you what is true.
But you're saying...
But science can tell you what is real. I hope you understand what I'm saying. Because science is always conditional and relative. Science is never absolute. Even if you say, okay, gravity is absolute, it's not absolute. Because you could move 4 miles or 10 miles up and then there is no gravity.
But gravity on Earth is absolute. Gravity 5 feet away from
Earth is absolute. That's because it's relative to where you are.
I see.
It's not an absolute thing in another
science in a parallel universe.
Exactly.
Entirely different.
Exactly.
Let's talk a little bit more about this notion of a spiritual experience or a spiritual awakening that you mentioned. You were saying that to achieve this, you have to somehow divorce yourself from the mind. Is this possible?
Yeah, it's basically, again, once you're in present moment, then you're cleaning your mind. It's like mind cleaning. You're cleaning your mind out of like 75 or 80% of what makes it so busy. And then you have room for breathing, if you know what I mean. You have room for the spirit. Mm. It's just that you need to come to a realization that try to not be attached to these earthy dimensions. And the way of spiritual awakening is a detachment from all kind of earthy possessions.
But it all sounds so intangible. You know, how do you know that you've had one?
I don't know. Huh. I don't know. You just know.
Huh. Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes you just say, "Oh, okay," because of this, you know, and this, but you just know.
So sometimes you'll be going walking down the street or driving your car and coincidence suddenly happens that seems to defy all logic and reason, or you know, somebody's birthday falls on a certain date and it's like this coincidence that doesn't seem to make sense.
Right.
Is that a spiritual experience?
Anything that doesn't make sense has a potential to be a spiritual experience. It shouldn't make sense. If it makes sense, then it's not a spiritual experience.
And that's because
making sense is common, like making a common sense. It's a mind job to make sense of something.
That's how our minds work. We put things in order.
Yes. And sometimes we need that. We need things to make sense.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes we don't need to make sense. Sometimes we need to not use the mind and not the logic and not the common sense and not the science and not the norms and not the 2 + 2 = 4 and just put them all aside.
But what happens when things make too much sense, in that not only 2 + 2 = 4, but I'll give you an example.
Okay.
So in the year of 2011, My birthday is April 23rd. Mm-hmm. My dad's birthday is August 23rd. And then if you take December 23rd, you create an equilateral triangle on the calendar of the year.
Right.
So when we figured out that on my birthday, my dad turned 2/3 of a century. On his birthday, I turned 1/3 of a century. And on December 23rd, I was exactly half his age in days.
Okay.
How is this? This is the chance of this happening is 1 in millions. So
or maybe less.
What does this mean? You know.
I don't know. It's just interesting. Why do we have to always make things to have a meaning or make sense? And why don't you just enjoy the process and just say, "Oh, this is interesting," and just move on?
But is this God? Do you think this is God?
I don't know. Mm. I don't know. A lot of the questions you ask me, I really don't know, and I don't want to say, "Oh, yeah." I don't know how God works, so I can't tell you. All I can tell you is that I believe in Him, and I believe in God, and I believe in the process of, a designed universal, union and all that. But if you ask me how God thinks, I don't know.
Do you have examples like this that I just gave of instances in your life where you weren't able to explain them, but whether it be a coincidence or something just seeming to defy logic?
Almost every day.
Okay.
Almost every day. You know, the thing is, you need to allow that to happen.
Mm-hmm.
If Einstein says something so beautifully, says you could live your life based on there are no miracles, or you could live your life based on their miracles every day and every time and all of the times. Life is full of miracles. And what is a miracle? A miracle is something that you cannot define and you cannot understand and you cannot justify by science or knowledge.
And you think by achieving a spiritual experience or a state of spiritual awakening or enlightenment, you begin to have the ability to access these moments in life, these miniature miracles that are happening.
Yes.
And for you, that is your evidence that there is this other realm of the spirit, and whether you choose to call it God or
right.
the spirit of the universe or the spirit of nature, there's
exactly.
something.
Exactly.